Hi there, welcome back to Solar City Garage. And we're still on our Model T motor project. We want to put this engine on an engine stand with a special bracket that's made for Model Ts. But there's some stuff that we have to remove and get out of the way first to make it a little easier and even possible. So I think the first thing we'll start out with here is the starter. Who knows if the starter is any good or not, but at least it would be a good rebuildable core. So we will start by digging the crap out from around the screws, see what's there.
Jumps.
I think you guys can still see it, okay. So what we're gonna try and get off here is this cover. And there is some screws. Wow, this thing is really packed in there. Stuff is just as hard as a piece of wood. It's all part of the fun, right? Whoops. Ooh, so I want to show you a sneak peek in there. So you see the pile of stuff is growing. A lot of people think you can just take the screws out of the starter back here and just pull it through like a modern day starter. But the Bendix on the end of the starter is bigger than the hole in the magneto ring. So, alright. Now I don't know how I'm going to keep you guys. Let me take out a screw here. I'm gonna have to get a different screwdriver. Hold on. All right, I'm back. I also trying to work smarter, brought something for my knees. Whoa. All right, let's try this again. So these screws, hey, look at there, that one turns right out. I know my big melon's in the way. I'm gonna get a light, you know, almost be prepared. There we go. All right, we'll put some light on the old actions here. Let me stick my big melon in the way again. Yep, it's there. Of course, full of crapola. This is a real treat to do in the car. Uh-oh. That's gonna be a problem, lady. Oh. Not good. Get a hammer. Over here, stick my big melon in the way again. Not good, folks. We'll let a little screw get us down. Let's see if we can get this one out. Hey, that screwdriver bent. It's a bad day. It's in there first. Oh, see, that one comes out just like butter. I hate to wreck this Bendix cover. I guess Ford did make about 15 million Model Ts, not all the starters. So we can get that to loosen that screw. Aha, look at that. See, didn't have to get out the hammer or nothing. All right.
Sorry, redundancy.
All right, so I'm back.
A little distraction there. I moved you guys in a little closer, so maybe you could see what was going on. So we got to remove this Bendix. It has the spring on here, and when I took the cover off,
you guys can see that. Focus, focus, come on. Anyway, that's out of the front of the spring. That is a open bolt. So,
could have been catastrophic if this had been a running Model T. Looks like it's been broken for a while. So, those are the kind of things that ruin your day. The next thing we have to do is take off this other bolt here on the spring to be able to get this end off. Now, this starter, there, see, the end just broke loose. This bolt is supposed to have this tab bent over. Somebody didn't put that back and they had it off. So, you know, this bolt is a pin that goes in the shaft of the starter. And something else we have to pay close attention to is you see there's a keyway here. And there is a tiny little key in there.
Let's see where we at. Focus, focus. As you can see, that bolt has a little pin that locks that end piece to the shaft.
So now, this part here appears to be kind of stuck on the shaft. Because that front spring bolt is broken, we can remove the spring, which usually doesn't happen. Usually it stays bolted onto the back part. But our advantage is we can get in here and gently, maybe a little more than gently. Yeah, we're still gentle. So I always like to hold my hand under here in case that key falls, which is still in there. So that comes off. Now we're going to work on a look at that. Now, that is one tiny little key that without it, nothing works. So we're going to put that in our little box. Now, the rest of this starter here, now that that is out, is supposed to just slide right on off. So because this engine has been sitting, we're going to just lightly move it over the cap. We are not hitting hard. You can see I have a pretty small hammer. There we go. Well, alright. So I said too soon. Let's just keep tap, tap, tap. What's that one movie where he says tap to the tap to the? You know, folks, this still could be a good starter, so that's why we're being so careful. It is stuck, but it's probably just stuck in the bushing. So, you know, they only made these so long. So,
there is the rest of the starter drive for Bendix. So there,
so no real casualties. Look in there and see, it does have a ring gear, so there's some teeth that aren't bad. We'll throw that in the box too. Next thing I'll do is move you guys over here so we can try to take off the four starter screws. Yes, I said screws, because that's what they are. All right, back in a moment.
All right, welcome back to the other side of the starter.
We'll turn our light around here a little bit. And as you can see, starter, of course, has the same crap built up that was on the other side. Starter should have four screws in it. see the stuff falling out and up. Can you? So, let's see. Oh, so that one's loose. That one's loose. Crap, I don't know about this one. Sorry, I say crap a lot. I don't know what I should say. Junk, schmutz. Model T goo. Hey, that one turned. Now, this next one. Sorry if I have my big melon in the way. I'm gonna have to put the light down here somewhere. Ah, yeah. Well, you know, there is a screw down here. Don't be looking at the top of my gray hair either. In case I bend over and hit one of these things.
All right, can you still see?
All right, so let's take out the bottom screw. Well, that's what's great about working on this Model T stuff is up here in the rust belt. You know, if we're used to working on stuff that's absolutely rusted beyond belief. But these Model Ts, most of them, never saw the salt. Because we didn't use road salt back then. So yeah, there's some rust and some crust and stuff like that, but it's not the horror of the liquid chloride that they put down. Where you could take a 2012 and not many heads on the bolts. And believe it or not, these are just flat bladed screws. All right, one more to go. And then, well, these starters are kind of heavy. It's all cast. I'm sure it's stuck. There's a gasket in there. And however many years of stickage. So, I'm going to give it a little tap. And there it is. One starter. That is off. Ta-da! So, there we go. No real surprises. Here it is. Let's go. All right, I'm gonna regroup here and what we gotta do next, and then we'll be back.